This problem, we have metallic iron, and it's in a body center cubic structure. So remember, this means an atom in each corner and one in the center of a cube. And it says the length of the edge of this cube, this length is 287 picometers, which is 287 times 10 to the minus 12 meters. And what it wants to know is, what's the density of iron? In other words, in grams per cubic centimeter. So we want to calculate the density, which means the mass over the volume. We want to determine the mass. So periodic table, 55.85 grams per mole. And so the number of grams for an atom, because we're looking at just at this cube, and this cube is going to contain an atom in the center, plus it has an atom in each corner, but they're shared amongst eight of these cubes. So we have eight corners, but only 1/8 is in this cube, so we have a total of two atoms of iron. Now the mass of one atom, we have to use Avogadro's number. This is going to give us the grams per atom. Then by multiplying by two atoms, we'll obtain the number of grams of iron. So our next step then is determine the volume of this cube. Well, this is 287 times 10 to the minus 12 meters cubed. So notice I first cubed each of the terms just to make sure I have my decimal places correct. Minus 29 cubic meters. Notice that we want this in cubic centimeters, so we'll do that when we calculate the density. So the density is the mass over the volume. So let's now convert units. 1 meter is 10 squared centimeters. So 1 meter cubed, 10 squared centimeters cubed. Now if we do this multiplication, of course meters cubed cancel, and we're going to have grams per cubic centimeter. And notice again that I've tried to be careful with my exponents here. So this is grams per cubic centimeter. Then we can also do a check. Does this number seem reasonable? Well, we know iron is much denser than water, and water has a density of about 1 gram per cubic centimeter. So at least it seems ballpark to be a reasonable number.